Friends, last time we have studied different points about the absorption, like applications of absorption and absorption found application in different field, like the chromatography, gas mask, formation or production of high vacuum, as well as in catalysis also, there is use of absorption process in chromatography. Today about the catalysis and different type of catalysis we have to study. In chemical reactions, which takes place in industry, also they takes place in the presence of catalyst. That chemical reactions, many chemical reactions takes place in industry are catalyzed by using some catalyst, so that overall phenomenon is known as the catalysis, that is called as the catalysis. So what is catalyst? See, first of all, in a chemical reaction, substance, chemical substance which is used in a chemical reaction, which increases the rate of reaction, without undergoing permanent change, that chemical substance is called as catalyst. That is known as the catalyst. Means in a chemical reaction, substance which is used, that substance without undergoing the permanent change, without undergoing the chemical change, increases the rate of reaction. It increases the rate of reaction, and that is called as the catalyst. It is known as the catalyst. That is called as catalyst. Now here, what is catalysis? This phenomenon of catalyst used in a chemical reaction, that is called as the catalysis. That is known as the catalysis. Now there are two types of catalysis. There are two types of catalysis, and this type of catalysis are of two types. That is, first one, homogeneous catalysis, and later we have to study heterogeneous catalysis. So homogeneous catalysis means what? Homo means same. So homogeneous catalysis means it is the catalysis. This is the catalysis in which physical state of reactants and catalyst are same. Physical state of reactant and catalyst exist in same physical state. Reactant used in a chemical reaction and catalyst used in the chemical reaction have same physical state, then that type of the catalysis is called as homogeneous catalysis. Now see examples of homogeneous catalysis. Example 1, in decomposition in the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide iodide ions are used as catalyst and physical state of this hydrogen peroxide and physical state of this iodide ions both are in same physical state, both are in aqueous state, so it is the example of homogeneous catalysis. See reaction, that is H2O2 aqueous state reaction is take place in the presence of iodide ion, that is aqueous state. There is formation of twice of H2O liquid and what, that is the O2 gas. So this is nothing but the homogeneous catalysis. In this reaction, reactant, that is the hydrogen peroxide, is in aqueous state and iodide ions are in also aqueous state. Both exist in the same phase. Therefore, it is the example of homogeneous catalysis. Then next one reaction, that is sulfur dioxide gas when burnt in air or oxygen in the presence of nitric oxide gas as a catalyst. So here also reactant have gaseous state and NO also in gaseous state, right? Reactants and catalyst have same phase, same physical state to produce the sulfur trioxide gas. Balance this equation by taking here 2 and here also 2. So point is that in this both in this reaction both, that is the sulfur dioxide, oxygen and nitric oxide, nitrous oxide, they all in same phase. Therefore, that is the homogeneous catalysis. Next one, example of homogeneous catalysis, that is nothing but the esterification reaction. Carboxylic acids, aqueous state. Then here, what, that is the ester hydrolysis of ester also. You can consider this reaction, ester hydrolysis or hydrolysis of ester plus H2O liquid in state. Here H2SO4 also in aqueous state. So ester is taken in aqueous state, water is in liquid state. There is formation of carboxylic acids and alcohol, liquid carboxylic acid, aqueous state. So here also the reactant and catalyst used in this reaction, sulfuric acid, are in the same phase. Therefore, that is also example of the homogeneous catalysis. So don't forget, homogeneous catalysis are the catalysis in which all the reactants and the catalyst in same phase, same physical state or the same phase. So that is nothing but the what, that is homogeneous catalysis. Also you have to remember that enzyme catalysis takes place in animals. Enzyme catalysis is an important type of what, that is the homogeneous catalysis. So what are the food we are eating? Apan je kai anna khato, food which we are eating, they are in the liquid state or solution form, and enzymes present in our stomach also in the aqueous state. Therefore they all, the reactant and the catalyst or enzymes, are used as catalyst to increase the rate of digestion or that metabolic process increases by using the enzyme as catalysis, and they are in the same phase. Therefore, that is also important example of homogeneous catalysis. Homogeneous catalysis. Second type of catalysis is heterogeneous catalysis. Heterogeneous catalysis. So see, heterogeneous catalysis is the catalysis. It is the catalysis in which reactants of chemical reaction and catalyst have different physical states. They are present in different phases, so that is called as the heterogeneous catalysis. यानी कि अगर रिएक्टेंट और कैटेलिस्ट जो रिएक्शन में यूज किया है, अगर वो रिएक्टेंट एंड कैटेलिस्ट का फिजिकल स्टेट सेम नहीं है, रिएक्टेंट की फिजिकल स्टेट अलग है, कैटेलिस्ट की फिजिकल स्टेट अलग है, so that type of the catalysis is called as the heterogeneous catalysis. That is known as the heterogeneous catalysis. So in this type of catalysis, the physical state of reactant and catalysis are not same. Catalysts are different in physical state. That is known as the heterogeneous catalysis. For example, here see examples of heterogeneous catalysis. That is the catalytic hydrogenation of oils into fats is the example of heterogeneous catalysis. How we have seen, that is nothing but the ethylene. Suppose here you take carbon-carbon double bond are present in oil. Hydrogen gas is added in it in the presence of nickel as catalyst. So here it is gaseous physical state. This is gaseous physical state. And nickel is in solid physical state. Alkyne hydrogenation. Reactants are gases and catalyst present in solid physical state. So here there is formation of the saturated hydrocarbons or alkanes are obtained. So that is nothing but the heterogeneous catalysis. It is the example of heterogeneous catalysis. Or second one example is aldehydes and ketones, when hydrogenated in the presence of nickel as catalyst to produce as the primary alcohol, so here aldehydes liquid, hydrogen gas, nickel solid. So physical state of reactants and catalyst are different. Therefore, such type of catalysis is called as the heterogeneous catalysis. It is known as the heterogeneous catalysis. Now see another one example of this type, that is nothing but the preparation of ammonia preparation by Haber's process. So here see, this reaction is take place in the presence of catalyst, that is the nitrogen gas plus 3 hydrogen gas. Reaction is take place in the presence of Fe and KO2, or what, that is the Al2O3 as promoters, and Fe is used as catalyst. So in this reaction, potassium oxide, that is K2O, kiwa alumina tumhi use karu shakta, that is the alumina is used as promoter. What is the physical state of iron? Solid. Physical state of reactant are gases. So they are present in different physical state, and if they are present in different physical state, then that is called as the heterogeneous catalysis to produces in this reaction what that is the ammonia gas. So that is the heterogeneous catalysis. So catalysis in which the physical state of reactants and catalyst used in a chemical reactions are different, they are not present in same phase, same physical state, that is called as the heterogeneous catalysis. Catalytic hydrogenation of oils into fat, or catalytic hydrogenation of alkenes to alkane, catalytic hydrogenation of aldehyde and ketones into alcohol, or preparation of ammonia gas by Haber's process involves reaction of nitrogen and hydrogen in the presence of Fe as catalyst and potassium oxide or alumina as promoter. Here Fe is present in which phase? Solid. And reactants are present in gaseous phase. Therefore, that is nothing but the heterogeneous catalysis. Heterogeneous catalysis. So such type of reactions which take place in industry or laboratory takes place in the presence of catalyst. So catalysts are the substances which increases the rate of reaction without undergoing permanent change or the chemical change. So that is two type of catalysis here we have studied: homogeneous catalysis and the heterogeneous catalysis. Now see the next one point here we have to study. What is mean by inhibitor? Inhibitor and examples also we have to study. What is inhibitor? It is the chemical substance, which retard the rate of reaction, growth of reaction, that is called as the inhibitor. Chemical substances which decreases the rate of reaction, which retard the rate of reaction, so that is known as the inhibitor. म्हणजे असे केमिकल सबस्टन्सेस की जे केमिकल सबस्टन्सेस रिएक्शन मध्ये यूज केल्याच्या नंतर ते रिएक्शनचा रेट कमी करतात, इंक्रीज करण्याऐवजी डिक्रीज करतात. दिस टर्म इज एक्झॅक्टली अपोजिट टू दॅट ऑफ द कॅटलिस्ट. सो इनहिबिटर्स आर द केमिकल सबस्टन्सेस विच वेन यूज इन अ केमिकल रिएक्शन दे डिक्रीजेस द रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन. दे आर यूज्ड एज पॉइजन. So decreases the rate of reaction, that is called as the inhibitor. For example, chloroform CHCl3, this is the chloroform being used as an anesthetic in surgery. Any ka chloroform ka anesthetic use kiya jata tha pehle, magar chloroform if exposed to air and light, it oxidizes into a poisonous compound, that is carbonyl chloride, which is also known as poison. Agar chloroform लाइट और एयर के कॉन्टेक्ट में आया तो उसका कन्वर्जन पॉइजनस सब्सटेंस कार्बोनिल क्लोराइड और उसे ही पॉजिन कहते हैं इसमें हो जाता है. और दैट इज हाईली पॉइजनस कंपाउंड ड्यू टू विच दैट पेशेंट कैन बी डेड इफ सच क्लोरोफॉर्म इज यूज्ड एज एन एनास्थेटिक इन सर्जरी. देयरफॉर टू रिटार्ड द कन्वर्जन ऑफ दैट क्लोरोफॉर्म इन टू द कार्बोनिल क्लोराइड और पॉजिन, पहले तो प्रिकॉशन बहुत लेते हैं क्लोरोफॉर्म प्रिजर्व करते समय. इट इज स्टोर्ड इन अम्बर कलर वेल स्टॉपर्ड बॉटल एंड विच इज प्रिवेंटेड और विच इज केप्ट सेफ फ्रॉम द लाइट एंड एयर. अम्बर कलर बॉटल एंड वेल स्टॉपर पीओपी से उसका जो कैप है वो क्लोज करते हैं, ऊपर से पीओपी लगाते हैं. मगर उस बॉटल में इथेनॉल ऐड किया जाता है, एडेड इथेनॉल, एंड क्या होता है, दिस इथेनॉल इज यूज्ड एज इनहिबिटर। वो जो इथेनॉल है वो इथेनॉल इनहिबिटर का वर्क करता है, यानी क्या, कन्वर्जन ऑफ द क्लोरोफॉर्म इनटू पॉइजनस पॉजिन इज रिटार्डेड, इज डिक्रीजेस बाय इथेनॉल, एंड देयरफॉर इथेनॉल इज एडेड इन क्लोरोफॉर्म बॉटल टू रिटार्ड द ग्रोथ ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द कार्बोनिल क्लोराइड और टू कन्वर्ट टू डिक्रीज द रेट ऑफ कन्वर्जन ऑफ क्लोरोफॉर्म इनटू द पॉजिन। सो दैट टर्म इज नथिंग बट द इनहिबिटर, दैट इज नथिंग बट द इनहिबिटर। इन हाइड्रोजन पेरोक्साइड ऑल्सो द ग्लिसरॉल इज एडेड, सी एंड वी स्टडी दैट इज इन हाइड्रोजन पेरोक्साइड डीकंपोजिशन ऑफ हाइड्रोजन पेरोक्साइड इज प्रिवेंटेड, रिटार्डेड और डिक्रीजेस बाय द एडिशन ऑफ ग्लिसरॉल इन दैट वॉटर। सो व्हाट हैपेंस, सेकंड एग्जांपल ऑफ इनहिबिटर, हाइड्रोजन पेरोक्साइड चेंजेस टू ट्वाइस ऑफ H2NO2 गैस, दिस इज नथिंग बट लिक्विड वॉटर, बट हियर इन हाइड्रोजन पेरोक्साइड ग्लिसरॉल इज एडेड एंड that glycerol acts as inhibitor, it works as inhibitor। glycerol hydrogen peroxide ka conversion decomposition kam karta hai, that decreases the rate of decomposition of hydrogen peroxide, so this is about what that is the inhibitor। now we have to study next one point, it is nothing but the adsorption theory of adsorption theory of heterogeneous catalysis, adsorption theory of heterogeneous catalysis। so how the adsorption takes place in heterogeneous catalysis, that we have to study। The catalytic action occurs on the surface of catalyst and this mechanism involves the following steps, this adsorption or catalysis, heterogeneous catalysis occurs at the surface of catalyst, it occurs or it involves the following step, it is first one step is the adsorption of reactants, adsorption of reactants on the surface of catalyst, first step, adsorption of reactant on the surface of catalyst is the first step involved in it। Then second one step involved in it is the adsorption, means before the adsorption what happens, that is diffusion of reactant molecule, here what happened, they get diffused, after the diffusion adsorption takes place, adsorption of reactant molecules on the surface of their adsorbent, on the surface of their catalyst, on the surface of catalyst, after that what happens, this catalyst and reactants combines and there is formation of intermediate, पहले जो reactant है, gaseous reactant, they get accumulate or diffuse on the surface of catalyst, उसके बाद वो reactant के molecule catalyst के ऊपर adsorb होते हैं, adsorb होने के बाद क्या होता है, reactant और catalyst में बीच में reaction होती है, रिएक्टेंट और कैटलिस्ट के बीच में रिएक्शन होने के बाद एक इंटरमीडिएट कॉम्प्लेक्स अनस्टेबल कॉम्प्लेक्स अनस्टेबल इंटरमीडिएट फॉर्म हो जाता है और उसके बाद दैट इंटरमीडिएट डीकंपोजेस इनटू व्हाट दैट इज द प्रोडक्ट एंड कैटलिस्ट एज इट इज रिकवर्ड. इंटरमीडिएट और कॉम्प्लेक्स जो फॉर्म हुआ है वो डीकंपोज हो जाता है प्रोडक्ट में और कैटलिस्ट एज इट इज रिकवर्ड विदाउट एनी केमिकल चेंज. एंड देन लास्ट वन स्टेप इज डिसॉर्प्शन ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट मॉलिक्यूल्स from the surface of catalyst. In this way, this is nothing but the adsorption theory of heterogeneous catalyst. Diffusion of reactant on the surface of catalyst, adsorption of reactant molecule on the surface of catalyst, reaction between the reactant molecule and the catalyst to form intermediate. This intermediate unstable complex is formed. That intermediate decomposes into product and desorption of product or molecule from the catalyst, surface of catalyst. Catalyst as it is recovered. There is no any chemical change. There is no any permanent change observed in catalyst. Therefore, that is nothing but the catalyst. And here we can, in this way, write what that is the diffusion. Adsorption, let's see, first one step, diffusion ke baad kya hota hai, adsorption hone ke baad formation of intermediate, now intermediate form hone ke baad, waha kya ho jata hai, product formation, intermediate, it forms the product formation and product formation hone ke baad desorption of the product and catalyst as it is recovered. This is the mechanism involves or takes place during the heterogeneous catalysis. So this is about the catalysis and type of catalyst.